going to a different economy, and we're going to be learning more about that as we go. But clearly, we're learning that things can be done from remote locations. We're learning that technology can replace people even more than we thought.
We're not going back to the same economy. We're recovering, but to a different economy, and it'll be one that is more leveraged to technology. And I worry that that is going to make it even more difficult than it was for many workers.
In Silicon Valley, and my friends who work in technology know that what we did to the manufacturing workers, we are now going to do to the retail workers, the call center workers, the fast food workers, the truck drivers, and then even bookkeepers, accountants, insurance agents, lawyers, and on through the economy. So what happened to the manufacturing workers is a very clear sign.
And so we'll import Chinese-based CBDC technology. So it's going to be CBDC in a box, provided to you by the People's Bank of China.
But every stock, every bond, every currency, every commodity, every piece of art, every private business, every piece of real estate will eventually be a token on a blockchain, an entry on a ledger, permanent and immutable. We will have truth instead of trust, and we will save over $7 trillion a year. 6 to 8% of global GDP is wasted by the friction of the trust industry that's necessary when you have dual entry accounting. With triple entry accounting, which is what a blockchain is, mm-hmm. we get rid of all of that friction. It's a beautiful future.
Like what you see in China and their social credit scoring systems, right? If we get identity wrong, you know, it could be a tool to enslave humanity. And if we get it right, it could be a tool to liberate humanity. And as an American, you know, I'm obviously rooting for the one that's on the side of freedom.
Bitcoin is an international asset. And also, I do believe the role of crypto is, it's digitizing gold.
I actually believe this technology is going to be very important. Look at it. We have been part of a huge revolution in investing through ETFs. We believe that ETFs will be changing the whole way we invest. Many people still use it as a means, well, people are investing it for indexing. No, the majority of people who are putting money in an index, in an ETFs, are active investors that are buying exposure. The entire bond market is being transformed as we talk right now. I believe the next generation for markets, the next generation for securities will be tokenization of securities. And if we could have that distributed ledger that we know every beneficial owner, every beneficial seller, we all have our code, right, of who's buying, who's selling, instantaneous settlement. And think about it, it changes the whole ecosystem.
Chinese bank ICBC has been hit by a ransomware attack, and the U.S. Treasury market, as a result of that, has been disrupted. This, according to the Financial Times. We're going to get more right now with Bloomberg's Shanali Basak. Shanali, what do we know?
Listen, we have the Financial Times now reporting that ICBC, one of China's largest banks here, was hit with a ransomware attack. And remember, they're a very significant intermediary in the Treasury market. The SIFMA has told its members that this has been part of the reason here, that the system is kind of clogged up, if you will. During that auction that we saw a little bit before, the attack had prevented ICBC, according to the Financial Times, from settling Treasury trades on behalf of other market participants. A large executive at a major bank also telling the paper that such a large party on the fixed income clearing corp creates major concerns, potentially impacting the liquidity of Treasury markets.
Now, it was not just a poor auction. It was absolutely lousy, and when the dealers have to step in to save a treasury auction, that's a rare occurrence. And
very much a traditionalist. I like staying with the dollar. You know that from when I was there. It's make the dollar the choice. I hate when countries go off the dollar. I would not allow countries to go off the dollar, because when we lose that standard, that will be like losing a revolutionary war. That will be a hit to our country, just like losing a war. And we can't let that happen. And too many countries now are fighting to get off the dollar. And
welcome to the Crypto Teacher. And guys, please like and subscribe if you do like what you're listening to. please inform your friends and family and spread all over social media. It is imperative that we get back to learning finances and understand how the world really works, because once we understand how the world really works, we understand that it is all planned out. Now, I want to thank those who purchased the books Crypto Teacher and the New World Order book. Remember, the New World Order book shows you how the world really works, and it is definitely time for you to wake up out of that sleep, especially in the times that we're in right now. And 2024 is going to be one of our most entertaining years. We have the presidential election. We have the drums a beating. We have the emerging markets going to be flipping the switch on the fourth industrial revolution. Now, we had the Fed signal rate cuts, but remember, guys, they haven't cut rates yet. So we know the massive magicians are about to set up that distraction. So therefore, they can cut rates while we still have inflation. And in the fourth quarter, once the election is over, we know the movie begins. And also, guys, I want to thank those who purchased the three kids' books, It's Time to Reeducate. Also, much love to those who donate to the Cash App Patreon. Much love. Keep it coming. Guys, if you're not a part of the Patreon, make sure you're donating to the channel through the actual Cash App. But guys, this next Bitcoin and crypto bull run is going to be a utility run. So you want to make sure you have the cryptos that have real utility. And much love to those who are shopping at both stores. Keep it coming. And of course, guys, we get into Bitcoin and cryptos first.
Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel.
And right now we have Bitcoin and crypto pulling back as expected. Guys, remember, we have options, but get yourselves in position. Remember, we're the only game in town, and we know we move up at the beginning of the month. And remember, the crypto teacher told you. Now, we had jobs report come out today, 303,000 jobs. And guys, we know it's going to be revised all the way down. They've been doing this every single month, but we know the revision doesn't get reported. And we know the sheep are definitely not going to look it up. And remember, the crypto teacher told you. Now, guys, do not forget to pay attention to the actual indicators. We have yield rates moving up. And I told you, yield rates are going to be creeping on up, guys. We have the dollar up. We have volume and crypto up. We have Tether and USDC. And we have U.S. PayPal customers will be able to use stable coins for international payments, enabling cross-border payments through its Zoom service. Now, we also have Athena Labs as Bitcoin as USDE backing asset. Now, we have the Fed and the repo is at $438 billion. And now we have the Fed members coming out and saying we may not get any rate cuts at all this year. And guys, we've seen this movie before. They're just kicking the can down the road. Remember what I told you, there's going to be a crisis in order for the Fed to cut. All the inflation that we have now is all corporate greed. Remember, guys, we're in a fragmented world. They want these rates higher for longer to break up this whole legacy economy. And you're talking about globally, not just in the United States. So then therefore, the fourth industrial revolution can rise, where the robots, algorithms, and drones take the economy over, pay each other with crypto, and the sheep go inside the metaverse. So when we're seeing all this disruption, remember, it's for the digital economy. So I don't care whether it's in housing, I don't care whether it's in construction, finances, the supply chain, everything is being turned upside down. The masses, the sheep, they can see it, but they don't know the reason why. And if you understand the reason why, you can get ahead of it, so therefore you can invest properly. Remember, those who are conscious are 10 to 20 years ahead. Those who not are 10 to 20 years behind, and they always fall for the devil's tricks. We've seen this in history so many times. And remember, the crypto teacher told you. Now, don't forget about the spot Bitcoin ETFs. Of course, we have BlackRock, Fidelity, and Grayscale all down right now. Now we have Monochrome Spot Bitcoin ETF expected to launch within 2 months. And remember, this digital economy is global. This one is in Australia. We know Hong Kong has got a lot of attention this year. Remember, this is a plan. It moves in phases. But getting over into a little crypto news. We have Uniswap tops $2 trillion in trading volume. Also, we have Coinbase, after 8 months launching in Canada, secures registration as a restricted dealer. And remember what Brian Armstrong stated. Coinbase was building the digital economy. That was one of the first videos I did when I first started, because he laid out the plan. And because majority of the world has access to a cell phone, now they can have a bank in their pocket. Banking the unbanked, or is it enslaving the unslaved? Now we have Sony Bank to conduct a stablecoin trial on Polygon. And we know gaming is definitely the future. And we know people are going to be getting paid just to play games. And how are they going to get paid? That's right, through tokenization. Remember, millennials and Generation Z are always the target. Remember, it's called Generation Z because it's the last generation as we know it. And remember, the crypto teacher told you. And then lastly, we have Brad Garlinghouse going after CoinDesk. And of course, it's about the launch of the stablecoin, and the article made it seem there's a desperate pivot away from XRP. Guys, remember, XRP is a synthetic stablecoin. It's an IOU, which moves real money, which moves real value. And that's the reason why I stated yesterday, gave you the example of the government using Stellar to move USDC. Only thing Ripple is doing is cutting out the middleman. Now they can move their own stablecoin, the same way they started their own CBDC platform. So now these smaller central banks, not the big ones, because we know the big central banks are going to have their own private network, but these smaller central banks can now use Ripple's CBDC platform along with the stablecoin, so they have all the infrastructure right there. Remember, the whole point of these crypto projects is to make it seamless and interoperable. And remember, the crypto teacher told you, because he knows, when it comes to the NWO, it's all planned out. If you guys, all I have for you, don't forget about the books, Crypto Teacher and the New World Order book, plus the three kids books, It's Time to Reeducate. Also, new to cryptos, Coinbase, BitTrue, Binance, do not forget book links and crypto links are in the description. The stock channel, guys, don't forget to go like, subscribe, spread everywhere. You have your Kobo, your ChipSize, your banking, your gaming. While everybody's sitting at home, get on stocks, the Seaver, the biotech stocks. And while everybody's at home wishing they were still getting that free money, what are they doing? Drinking and smoking weed. Don't forget about those stocks, and you have a wonderful day. Most powerful person in the world is the storyteller. The storyteller sets the vision, values, and agenda of an entire generation to come. Steve Jobs. And guys, you know I truly believe in this. When you look at the New World Order, they're the storytellers. And that's the reason why I wrote my New World Order book. But guys, now it's time to change the current generation. And I wrote three kids' books. You know, I love the Trinity because I understand the power that's in it. So I have three books. We have an opportunity to change the generation, to educate not just me, but I want to show you that I take action on a daily basis. And I want you to take action on a daily basis, whether it's your job, whether it's in your community. We have an opportunity right now to educate the masses. I posted this on my Twitter account. Please share, but this is a short clip of the three books. There's going to be a clothing line and action figures. Please get these books for your kids, nephews, cousins, friends, so therefore we can start the re-education now. Because as we see, the fourth industrial revolution foundation is definitely here. Robots, algorithms, drones, taking humanity out the picture. We have to re-educate. But let's get into the video.
Part 1. King Joshua and Grandma Tam save the village. Part 2. King Joshua and Grandma Tam save New York from COVID-33. part 3. King Joshua and Grandma Tam goes to China.
It's mandatory to get part 1, part 2, and part 3 of this series. It's time to re-educate Generation Z.